ओके
सो आई हैव टेकन योर अटेंडेंस, नाउ वी रिवाइज अवर चैप्टर ऑफ द सिविक्स, दैट इज व्हाई डू वी नीड पार्लियामेंट. एज वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस यस्टरडे डिफरेंस बिटवीन लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा, आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग इट टू यू अगेन बिकॉज देर आर मैनी न्यू स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो. ओके, एज यू ऑल नो दैट पार्लियामेंट इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ इट इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा प्लस प्रेसिडेंट. फाइन, ऑल दीज थिंग्स कंसिस्ट इन अवर पार्लियामेंट. नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू लोकसभा फर्स्ट. लोकसभा, इन लोकसभा वी आर हैविंग टोटल 543 इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स, मीन्स वी इलेक्ट दीज मेंबर्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ द वोटिंग. बट इन टोटल वी आर हैविंग 545 मेंबर्स. As I already told you that 543 are elected members plus 2. These are Anglo-Indians. Anglo-Indians, I will explain you. First, listen that these 2 are nominated by the president. Okay. And these 543 are elected by the general people by using their voting. Anglo-Indians are the peoples who are not exactly Indians. As we all know that we provide equal rights to each and every person who are living in the India. But Anglo-Indians are the peoples whose forefathers are living in India. So now they are also the part of the India. So these 2 are, they don't have any right to contest election with these peoples, but president choose them by his or her own way on the basis of area of their work or experience they are having. Okay, so this was about Lok Sabha, that in total we are having 545 peoples, 543 are elected members and 2 are nominated by the president. Okay, now Rajya Sabha. In Rajya Sabha, we are having 245 total members. Fine. From these 245, 233 are the ministers who are chosen by the MLAs. Rest 12. Fine. These 12 ministers are nominated by president only on the field of their work or on the basis of their experience. These 233 ministers, these are chosen by the ministers or these are chosen by the MLA of Lok Sabha. Okay, first clear all these things. After that, I will explain you the proper functioning, that how Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha elect their ministers. Okay, I hope the total members of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha is clear to you all. Now, first I will explain you the proper functioning of the Lok Sabha. See, in the Lok Sabha, there is suffrage. Suffrage means right to vote. In Lok Sabha, there is direct participation of general people who are having age of 18 or above it. Okay, so we are providing equal voting right to them. MLAs of Lok Sabha are elected by the general people. And these MLAs belongs to the proper constituency. ठीक है, constituency होती है आपकी. So these MLAs which contest election, of the Lok Sabha are directly related to the constituencies of various regions. When we providing giving our vote to these MLAs, then party who will get more than 50% votes, means 50% plus one, they were in the majority. Okay, another one are in the minority. They are in the minority. So the political party who are in majority will form the ruling party. Okay, ruling party. Minority will form the opposition party. Okay, what I told to you, that majority ruling party, minority will frame opposition party. Opposition, we can say that second largest. Ruling party are the largest party who are getting more vote as compared to the other political party. And opposition party means second largest party. So like this, jo ruling party hoti hai, ruling party will frame their own government. By taking example, let's suppose that from 543, there are 382 votes are of BJP. Okay. Rest all are related to the Congress. Now more than 50% votes are in the favor of BJP. So now BJP is in ruling party. Congress is in opposition. BJP is in ruling. So this is the proper procedure that how we choose members of the Lok Sabha by directly win our voting rights. Now we will explain members of Rajya Sabha. अब देखिए राज्यसभा है, लोकसभा ये एमएलए. लोकसभा में हमने क्या चूज किए, वी चूज एमएलए. नाउ दिस एमएलए विल चूज द मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ राज्यसभा. ओके, एंड फ्रॉम दिस मिनिस्टर दे विल चूज ओनली 233 मेंबर्स. ये जो लोकसभा के जो मेंबर्स हैं, यही क्या करेंगे, दे विल चूज द मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ राज्यसभा, बट दे विल चूज ओनली 233 मेंबर्स. रेस्ट 12 आर नॉमिनेटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर फील्ड वर्क और ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द एक्सपीरियंस विच दे आर हैविंग. ओके, इज दिस क्लियर टू यू ऑल? सो दिस इज द प्रॉपर functioning that how Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha works. Parliament consists of both the houses. Your Lok Sabha is your lower house and your Rajya Sabha is your upper house. Lok Sabha, you can also say House of People, because in this people choose their MLA by using their voting right. And Rajya Sabha, as the name suggests, Rajya means state. So you can say Council of State. Okay. Now we will understood the functioning of Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, what is the role of Rajya Sabha? See, every development of the state and any problem which the state government is facing will discuss by the Rajya Sabha in the parliament. Okay, CM of various states will discuss all the issues and all the policies by which we can do more development in any particular area. Now let me explain you that how any particular bill become an act and how the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha will perform when they need to pass any bill. How any bill become an act, or you can say law. To frame any bill or any law, it is compulsory that the bill should be passed from both the houses, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, and after it, President will sign that particular bill. And after passing from both the houses, along with the signature of the President, the bill become an act. Suppose, here is the Lok Sabha. They pass any particular bill. Let's take example CAA. CAA was a bill which passed by the Lok Sabha. Now Lok Sabha passed this bill and sent this bill to Rajya Sabha. Okay. Now Rajya Sabha will look after in this bill that what is which area it will cover, to whom it will affect. Okay. Rajya Sabha will consider all these matters, but it is not compulsory that if any bill is passed from the Lok Sabha, then Rajya Sabha will also need to give his permission to that. Okay, it's not compulsory for the Rajya Sabha that it has given permission only. It can deny also, it can raise issue also, it can ask questions also, that there are some points on which we are not agree. We want explanation of such points because they are having on doubt. Now, what will happen? If Rajya Sabha is not passing any particular bill, then President asks question to the Rajya Sabha that what is the reason behind your rejection? Why do you don't want to pass this particular bill? After giving the explanation, if the President feels that reason given by the Rajya Sabha is a valid reason, then the President will also give instruction to the Lok Sabha that there are some particular areas or there are some particular points or contents in the bill which are not applicable to all the citizens and which are maybe they are violating the rights, the fundamental rights of the citizens. So that can be the reason that why Rajya Sabha is not passing the bill. But if the reason given by the Rajya Sabha is invalid, then President can ask them to pass that particular bill. Okay, so this was the proper functioning that after passing from both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, now here is the role of the President. Okay. Now President will look into the matter that what is the actual matter over here. Sometime it happened that if any bill is passed from the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, it is not compulsory that President will sign that particular bill. If President feels that there is nothing such content in that particular bill, or there is no need for such kind of bill, or if President feels that this bill will be not in the favor of the social welfare, that then President can deny to sign that particular bill. And without the signature of the President, the bill cannot become any law. But if the President feels that all the content included in the bill are in the social welfare or are for the development of the country, then President will sign that particular bill. And after passing from both the houses, and when President will sign that particular bill, the bill will become an act. Okay. Act, you can say law. When we discuss the functions of the parliament, then also we are having a particular heading over there that the main function of a parliament is to frame laws. So in our that heading, we can explain all this functioning or all this process, that how any particular bill become an act and what is the role of a parliament to frame any rule or to frame any law. Okay, so I hope the proper functioning of the parliament is clear to you with the help of this particular point only. And we already discussed difference between Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Now we will discuss the functioning of the parliament. Okay. Which is parliament? Generally, is the legislature. Legislature. Fine. You all know that we are having three organs of the government. One is judiciary, another is legislature, next one is executive. Okay. Executive is the last one. So when we are talking about the parliament, then we discuss this organ of the government, that is legislature. What is the full form of MLA? Member of Legislative Assembly. Yes. So this L, this legislature is relates to this only. Okay. That's why we can say that parliament is the second function or second organ of the government. MLA. Member of the Legislative Assembly. And MP, what do you mean by MP? Member of Parliament. Okay. So basically, the second organ of the government is our Parliament. So you can assume that how important it is. Next is functions of the Parliament. Functions. First, to control and guide. Fine. As I already discussed with the proper process of a particular bill, that how any bill becomes in law. Become a law. So in that I discuss with you that how parliament control and guide to the Rajya Sabha. Okay, here I want to explain you one thing also, that let's take example that if Lok Sabha is passing any bill and 60% Indians are not in the favor of that particular bill, so do you think that government should pass that particular bill? Maximum public are not in the favor. They are in the against of that bill. Means 40% are in favor and 60% are in against. So what will be your decision if you are a government? You will think that 60% are not in a favor. They are in against. So we should not pass that particular bill. No. You should not think like this. You should think like that. That we need to explain that why these 60% are not in the favor. But taking example of CAA. Yes, more than 60% were in against. Only 40% or less than 40% were in favor. Because these 60% actually do not know that what exactly CAA is. Unhe pata hi nahi tha ki CAA actually hai kya. When government explain them that what is exactly CAA is, and it is not related to all the Muslims of the country, then people are able to understand that why government want to pass this bill. When government explain them that people who are living in the India since the time of independence are the part of India only. Government is not marking any type of question on them. Okay. So now they are able to understand that why government want to pass the CAA. They are in their favor only because the opposition party create a lots of disturbance and they explain negative things to the general public. So it can be happened that if 60% are in against, it is cannot be true. It can be false also. Because अगर majority 60% की है तो जरूरी नहीं है कि वो सही ही है. But government now is in a very better form that why these 40% are in favor and why these 60% are in against. That's why still government passed this order and explained to the general public that what are the proper guidelines of that particular bill. So this is the role and this is the function of the parliament to control and guide to the government and to the general people also. That if government is working on any kind of bill or if government want to frame any particular law, so there is a reason behind that. We are thinking for the social welfare only. Okay, next function is to frame law or to formulate law. For that I already explained you the process of parliament, that how any bill become a law. You can write that explanation over here. Okay, so this was all about your chapter, that why do we need parliament. Okay, so I hope your all the doubts are clear now. If you're having any kind of doubt and any kind of query, then you can ask. Yes, bache, I'm waiting for your doubts. Rashmi, do you have any doubt? Do you want to ask any question, bache? Okay. So, I hope now all the doubts are clear. So, this was all about our today's class. So, thank you so much. Have a nice day, all of you.